Hi, my name's Chad Imhoff. I'm a marriage and family therapist and counselor, and I'm sitting outside on a Saturday, and we were going to do some projects like we kind of do on Saturdays, stuff around the house, and I was doing these chairs, these metal chairs. They're old. They were my grandma's and grandpa's, and I was kind of scrubbing them and thinking about, like, with a wire brush and thinking about, like, man, this is a good way to do grief, if there is such a thing as good grief. It's a good thing, especially, I think, for people that like to put their hands on stuff, and I'm somebody who likes to work on things and do that. As I'm kind of scrubbing this chair down and working on this chair, I'm kind of thinking about my grandma. I'm kind of going, oh man, they sat in their front yard down in Texas in these, and they've had these for, I mean, they had them for 40 or 50 years. And I'm kind of just doing this project and thinking about how they lived and who they were. And honestly, I'm kind of sweating and just kind of going through, man, I miss this about them, or I miss that about them. And these were the good things, or these were the bad things. And even the chair, I was thinking, man, some of this I'm rubbing off is probably nicotine. They smoked their whole lives, and she died from cancer. So there's some frustration with that, right? But just kind of sitting here kind of going, this is a good way for me to grieve. You know, this is a good way for me to kind of do a project and be intentional about thinking about the people that I've lost or loved ones and kind of move forward. And I think a lot of times people say, oh, you should go grieve that, or oh, you need to spend time grieving the people you've lost. And I think that sometimes these things become cliche in our culture. But what I mean when I say grief is just sit down and be intentional. Think about what are the good things that they did, what were the hard things that they did, and how do I say goodbye to them and still honor them? And one of the ways that I plan on honoring them is with some of these things that I'm refinishing and redoing. You know, it's not that I want to get caught up with getting the stuff from my grandmother or from, you know, that sort of thing. But I do want to take some things that mean something to me and then use them in a way that allows me to kind of grieve her, the loss of her, the loss of the person that she was. And that means the good things and the bad things and everything in between. But I was doing this project, and I'll show you guys some pictures of it. I'll add them in here and just kind of show you what it means. You know, the nice thing about being outside and sweating is you can kind of be sad and sweaty and tear up a little bit if you need to, or even just kind of put some energy to something. And I think sometimes that helps me kind of just burn off some of the grief too. Anyway, I was just thinking about it and thought I'd share it with you guys. Thanks for listening.